maximum value of autocorrelation function or maximum value of RXT. Maximum value of autocorrelation function or Rx tau, anything that you can say, which is kahan pe achieve hote sir, Rx 0 pe. This is what we have discussed in the previous videos, like previous question. Absolutely right. Second question, always remember total energy which is associated is nothing but equals to Rx 0. What? The maximum value hai na. Oh, please remember this point, okay? Very important. Quickly, I'm moving to the third point. Always remember, Sx of omega, either energy spectral density or power spectral density, anything that you can say, it is always gives you non-negative value, okay? Power spectral density is always non-negative. Clear? Fourth point, if xt is real, very, very important, then rx tau and sx omega in spectral density or power spectral density, yes or no, Fourier transform of rx tau. That means if xt is real, rx tau and the Fourier transform of rx tau, yes or no, is real and even. Sx omega is real and even. This is very important and we need to be very careful about this concept. Rx tau is real and even and Sx omega is real and even if your x of t is real. Now fifth point, if your x of t is, sir, haan, ye question mein puchne wala tha, sir, x of t agar imaginary ho gaya to, if your x of t is imaginary, then Rx tau and Sx omega, tell me about this thing, if your x of t is imaginary, your Rx tau is complex conjugate. What? Rx tau is complex conjugate and symmetric. But your Sx omega is real. You got this point? If x of t is real, Rx tau is real and even, and Sx omega is real and even. If x of t is imaginary, then Rx tau is complex conjugate and symmetric. Sx omega is real. Clear? Now moving on, we are in fifth point. Let's go to sixth point. Sixth point says, we are in fourth point. First point is maximum value, Rx 0, then Sx omega, Xt is real. Achai, this is your fourth point only. This is in one point. Let's move to sixth point. Sixth point says, you got the idea, na? Sixth point says, sorry, fourth point, na? Fifth point says, what are the points that I have discussed? Maximum value, Rx of 0, Sx omega, Xt is real, or X of t is imaginary. What are the points left? X of t has, there is another point I forgot to tell you. X of t has autocorrelation function Rx of tau and power spectral density Sx of omega, very important, if x of t has autocorrelation function Rx tau and power spectral density Sx omega, please remember this point, my dear friend, x of at has autocorrelation function rx at and power spectral density or energy spectral density, anything that you can say, 1 by a sx omega by a. See how it got deferred. But if you are doing the time scaling, it get affected. But if you do the time shifting, please remember, it get changed with time scaling, but it does not change with frequency. Time shifting. It get affected by scaling, but it never gets affected by shifting. So autocorrelation function is Rx tau, and power spectral density or energy spectral density is xx omega. It will going to be same. So I can write down here, it is unchanged. Accession reason ka questions are very, very important with time shifting. Got this point? I'd get changed with scaling. If you are doing a scaling, it get changed. Now this is your fifth point. What are the points that are left? Fifth point, then there is a sixth point. Hey, now if you include, if x of t is periodic, if your x of t is periodic with period tau, right, then Rx tau is also periodic with period tau. Very simple thing. So if you have, for example, if you have x of t is like a cos omega t plus phi, then Rx tau is nothing but a square by 2 cos omega tau only, like it will be in the same period. Moving on to a next point, what point that I forgot? I have discussed all these points. I have discussed, 1 second, I have discussed with you maximum value, energy value, power spectral density always non-negative, real event, real imaginary, complex conjugate and symmetry, then Sx omega is real. Okay, these points are done. X of t has autocorrelation function, this power spectral density is this, then scaling and shifting is here, periodic point is here. Okay, there is another point, seventh point, very important, look here carefully. Limit tau tends to infinity, Rx tau is always zero. What? Why, sir? Because when autocorrelation function tends to zero, autocorrelation function always tends to zero when tau tends to infinity. Sir? Remember this point. This is a very important point. Okay? You will not going to get anywhere this point. Eighth point. This is what we know actually. Okay, I'll write it down as a eighth point. Rx tau, that is your autocorrelation function, whose Fourier transform is, sir, energy spectral density, sir, absolutely correct. But if you take a RFG tau, that is cross correlation function, the Fourier transform is F of omega, G of omega star. We have discussed this point, na? This is nothing but F of omega, F of star omega, that is conjugate of this one. Please go through all these properties. What are the things that we have discussed today? We start our discussion from a very simple question, okay, in which conclusion we got this graph, and then we start with a ISRO question, okay, why it sends stationary random process. Very simple. Please write it down on your note, okay. All these notes will be available down in the description. So please go through all these notes and do write it down in your own language. Thank you so much for watching this video lecture. See you. Bye.